going to start next topic, management of chickens. Okay, next topic, management of chickens. Okay, right. So here, like in management of chickens, so first of all, here the poultry farmers rearing three types of birds. Those are first one. Broilers, second one, layers, third one, dual purpose, chickens. Okay, here the poultry farmers, they used to rearing three types of birds: broilers, layers, and dual purpose chickens. So here we know the why, as so we have to rear the broilers for the production of meat. Okay, we are rearing broilers for the production of meat, and we are rearing the layers for the production of egg. Okay, so in dual purpose chickens, we have to rearing these dual purpose of chickens for the production of both meat and egg. Okay, so here the poultry farming the keepers are rearing three kinds of hens: broilers, layers, and dual purpose chickens. Broilers we have to rearing the broilers for the production of meat, layers for the production of egg, and dual purpose chickens for the production of both meat and egg, right? So I think so these three kinds of birds they have rearing in different sheds. Okay, so different kinds of sheds, different sheds, and why? Because these three kinds of birds exhibit different behavior. Okay, and hence so here different principles manage how to be applied for rearing. Okay, now we have to observe the important principles in the poultry farming. Okay, so first of all, management of chickens. So here the poultry farmers are rearing three types of birds: broilers, layers, and dual purpose. Why? Because these are rearing separate sheds or separate houses. Why? Because they are exhibit different behavior, and hence different principles management have to be applied. So now we have to find out important principles of the management. Okay, important principles of management. So first one, before the arrival of the chicks into house, before arrival of the chicks. Okay, so before chicks arrival into the brooder house, we have to follow some instructions to there. Okay, so before entering to the brooder house, chicks before entering to the brooder house, we have to follow some instructions. First of all, brooder house and its surrounding area. Brooder house and its surrounding area, along with that equipments. What are the equipments present in the brooder house? And we should thoroughly cleaned and disinfected. Okay, so in brooder house, first of all, we have to brooder house and its surrounding area, and along with that equipments, we should have thoroughly cleaned and disinfected. Okay, and so that house we totally covered with deep litter, that depth nearly 8 to 10 centimeters. Okay, so that house totally covered with what? That deep litter. Okay, so why we have to cover with that house with deep litter? Because of that deep litter absorbing the chicks are hence that droppings, and in that dropping some moisture is there, that moisture was deep litter was absorbed. Okay, So, and you have to cover it with that house with deep lid. Okay, and you have to produce some heat to the brooder house 1 hour before for the arrival of the chicks. Okay, before arrival of the chicks, you have to produce some heat to that house 1 hour before. Okay, and next one, so we have to chicks you have to transport as early as possible and fed them immediately. Okay, we have to transport the chicks as early as possible and fed them immediately. Okay, and we have chicks we have to place in a car seat and adequate ventilation. Okay, chicks we have to place in a car seat and give adequate ventilation. Okay, proper adequate ventilation. And so how to place in each box like 10 nearly 10 hens. And okay, because what happen if we have to keep more hens, means what will happen, and we cannot control the overcrowding. So that's why to prevent the overcrowding, we have to take from hand to hand a square feet distance, and in box we have to keep nearly 10 hands. Okay, 10 hands. So, and also like that, before the arrival of the chicks into brooder house, we have to do like this. Okay, so before the arrival of the chicks, what we have to do first, brooder house and its surrounding, we have to clean the brooder house and its surrounding area at the time of what are the equipment present in that house. So we should clean those kinds. Okay, later, we have to cover it with deep litter. In that house, we have to cover it with deep litter, right? So, because of they have to observe the moisture of the chicks droppings. Okay, and we have to produce a heat before the arrival of the chicks 1 hour before. Okay, and we have to transport the chicks as early as possible to brooder house. Transported, we will fed with them. We will have to give some feeding to them. Okay, right. And next one, and we have chicks. We have to place in a car seat and with adequate ventilation. Okay, and we have to give from a proper space, a square feet distance to chick because of prevent the overcrowding. Okay, so this is about the before arrival of the chicks, and second one on the arrival of the chicks. So here, after arriving those chicks to brooder house, what we have to do? Okay, so here after arriving those chicks, we have to take out those chicks from the boxes immediately. So prevent the dehydration. Okay, so after arriving, we have to take out those hens in that boxes immediately because prevent the dehydration. Okay, and so for first 7 days we will give 23 hours. We have to provide 23 hours light for them. Why? Because they have to adapt the new environment. So that's why we have to provide light for 23 hours to those chicks. So they have to adapt that new environment. That's why we have to provide the first 7 days for them 23 hours light facility. Okay, and the next and third one, later we have to give some feed and water to them along with that vitamins. Okay, so we have to give some feed and water to them along with vitamins, right? And the next one, so we have to arrange the waterers and next feeders near the sheds, near the chicks. Why? Because if we have to arrange those waterers and feeders, means what will happen? Those chicks will immediately come and take that water and feed. Okay, so that's why we have to arrange those feeders and waterers near the chicks. Okay, feeders and water means like telugu neela tottelu and ahara tottelu antaru kada. So we have to arrange near the chicks. Okay, and so like we have to arrange these waterer and feeder. Yeah, so like every 25 hens will have to arrange one feeder and one waterer. Why? Because so those are in that house having so many hens. So that's why each nearly 25 hens we have to arrange one feeder and one water pipe. So to have to do like this, we have to prevent some infections and some diseases. So that's why we have to arrange like this. So we have to weigh each and every hen every 7 days. Okay, after arriving that house, each seven days. Okay, after each 7 days, we have to take some weight of those birds. Okay, and so and like first 7 days, we have to give them the feeding if any type of tray or newspaper. So by that time, what will happen? They have to easily identify that food. Okay, identify the feeding. That's why for the first 7 days, we have to give feeding for them. Okay, we have to give the feeding for them. Any tray or any newspaper. Okay, right? Like that, we have to do. And the next, we have to give the starting feeding. So first started feeding we have to give 0.5 kg pellets in 2 weeks. 0.5 kg pellets in 2 weeks. Okay. So first starter feed we have to give that bird 0.5 kg pellets. Pellets means some gulikal. So we have to those pellets we have to do like bowls and we will give that chicks and that birds, right? So first starter feed we have to give them starter pellets. We have to starter feed we have to give them 0.5 kg pellets for 2 weeks. Okay, and the next next grower feed pellets 1.5 kg. We have to give those for those birds for 2 weeks. Okay, and next letter finishers pellets we have to give those birds to 1.5 kg to 2 weeks. Okay, so first starter feed the pellets we have to give 0.5 kg 2 weeks and 1 point and grower fed we have to give 0.5 kg for those birds, the pellets in 2 weeks, and next finisher feed we from those birds and 1.5 kg pellets from 2 weeks. So like that we have to give feeding those chicks like this. Okay, and so these are the instructions we have to follow on the arrival of the chicks. Okay, so on the arrival of the chicks, first of all we have to take those chicks immediately from the boxes and to prevent dehydration. And the next first 7 days we will give 23 hours light. We have to provide 23 hours light for them because they have to adapt a new environment. Okay, and the next one, so immediately we have to give water and feed them along with the vitamins. And so then we have to arrange waterers and feeders near the chicks. Okay, we have to arrange each and every 25 hens, one waterer and one feeder. Okay, and we have to weigh those chicks, those birds every 7 days once. Okay, and next one, first 7 days we will give the feed for them. We will give the feed for from them by any tray or a newspaper. For the time they have to identify the food. Okay, and next later. And so we have to first starter give the first starter feed from the birds. Those pellets 0.5 kg 2 weeks, and next grower feed for the birds those pellets from 1.5 kg in 2 weeks, and finisher feed to them for the birds the pellets 1.5 kg for 2 weeks. Like this, the arrival of the chicks we have to do like this. Okay, and so in this poultry farming, these chicks are having chicks are caused by some stress. So that stress is caused by. So why they are causing stress? So first of all, why they are causing stress? Stress is caused by some noises by the barking of dogs, and next some automobiles and so like that, if any and also disturbances. So any noise, if they have any noise, they immediately feel some stress. And next, like if any strange person entered into that poultry farm, immediately they are having some fear. Okay, and so that's why if only one person every day entered into that poultry house and brooder house, and that person only observe each and every hen. So by that every hen or chick, by that time what will happen, that chicks are habited to that person. Okay, so if every day one person will go and observe the chick, means that the chicks are habited to that person, by that time they cannot have any kind of fear. Okay, so if any strange person will enter into that brooder house, means immediately they are having some fear, right? So they are habited to that one person only. How sheep and goats are habited to that shepherd, so like that those chicks are habited to that person. Okay, and if any change person will come, means they are having some stress. Okay, and if any climatic conditions was not good, by that time also they are having some kinds of stresses. So if any storms, okay, and heavy rains, so by that time also they are having some stress. Okay, and they are having some disturbances, and like if any time, like any predator will come, by that time they are having some stress and disturbances also. Okay, so like that they are having some disturbances and stress. Okay, but how they are having some stresses and they are having some disturbances also. Already some chicks are rearing in that brooder house. So by that time, if any new chick enter into that house, means if any person will come and place new chick in that place, means so what will happen if that chick will come outside. So by the time that chick having any disease or any microorganisms, means what will happen, that spread to another. So like that some disturbances are there, some community spread death rates have. So that's why they are, by the time also they are having some disturbances, right? And that if any new chick we have to enter into that house, means slowly we have to check that one and it sick or not, if they have any disease or not, and we have to check. And later we will enter into that chick to remaining chicks. Okay, we will place the chick in the remaining chicks. So we have to slowly habituate to the chick to all chicks. Okay, we have to slowly habituate the chick to all chicks. Okay, and next one, and another disturbances, or if maximum chicks are in only one room, means what will happen? So feeding problems are having. Okay, so that's why I said we have to arrange each and every 25 chicks one water and one feeder. Okay, we can't do like that, means what will happen, and feeding problems and water problems also there. So some are having good food, some are having not good food by the time, and some nutritional deficiencies are they are having some nutritional deficiencies. So that is one of the disturbances. Okay, and we have to rear those chicks from both male and female from up to suitable sex ratio. Later we have to separate both male and female chicks. Okay, and so without separate means some disturbances, so like that they are having some different disturbances, like any climatic disturbances, and next and if new chick will come in, that is one of the disturbances. So, and water disturbances and feeding disturbances. So, like that, they are having some disturbances also. So, that's why, so we have to take some precautions. So, after arriving and before arriving the chicks into brooder house. So, we have to follow the proper instructions, and we have to rearing those chicks in a proper way. Okay, so this is about the management of chickens. So here we observe before arrival of the chicks and on the arrival of the chicks. Okay, and those are having some stresses, and we observe this one also, and I explain this one also, and they are having some disturbances. So I explain this one also. So I hope all of you understand, and if you have any doubt, please ask me personally. And okay, and you have to prepare your running notes, and thank you. Okay students, today signing off. Next lesson we will be discussing next lecture. Okay, bye students. I'm Satyavani, MSc Zoology.